two. Sankey fumbles. Ball's on the deck. Battle for it. And the Broncos say they've got it. Southwick will take off. Drives for the first down. Now with a first down and 10, Southwick with an empty backfield. Offensive line does a fine job. And it is complete. Reaching for the touchdown is Boldemire. Bryce is looking downfield, takes off, and he's sacked. As time goes down the near side, it's intercepted.
One thing Washington knew, they had to protect the football to have a chance today. They've got two turnovers. There's a fumble. They've not been able to protect Price at all. Every time he's back to throw, he's either sacked or he's got a lot of pressure to deal with.
There's third down and 14 for Southwick. Backed up inside the 10-yard line. Scrambles out. On the run, comes back to Miller for the first down. Across the 25-yard line. Bails him out on a long third down.
Rushing three and dropping eight. When you drop eight into coverage, what it forces you to do is communicate. You've got to be able to communicate as receivers are leaving one zone and running into another. That time he bought time by being able to scramble away from the pressure and opened it up across the middle of the field.
18 yards, coming along, got a man open.
Good throw, maybe.
Double pass. Wide open, caught. Reaching for the touchdown.
Hello, this is PJohn56 with the SB Nation Boise State Blog 1 Bronco Nation Under God, and I thought I would do an early 2013 roster review for Boise State, and I want to break it down by position groups. And this is going to be probably a 10-part series. This is just part one, the introduction. The gist of this project is to just get a bird's eye snapshot of where we sit as far as experience. How many redshirt seniors do we have? How many of our star guys are redshirt freshmen or sophomores? And what does that mean for the upcoming season? I'll give you some of my thoughts on that, and I'm looking forward to seeing any of your comments and feedback. I do want to let you guys know that there is an excellent fan post out there. I cannot remember who wrote it. I believe this is a pretty young guy. I think he's just a senior in high school. But wow, it's really well written. He covers quite a few of the impact players and goes over the year that they had, the progress that they made, and then he gives some projections of his own of how he feels they might do next year or this upcoming season. And if I can find that fan post, I'll link it in each one of these videos because it's really worth the read. I kind of felt like I was reading a review in Athlon Sports Magazine. I just was really impressed with this young man's writing ability and cognitive thinking skills. And I encourage all of you to take a look at that as really a more in-depth look than what you're going to get right here. This is the quick and dirty. Before we get into that, I would like to say that I think this team is entering into another stage of development. Last year was kind of the rebuilding phase, and we did big things. The offensive coordinator got online with the quarterback. The scheme was put in place. The guys worked on execution, and personnel groups were ironed out and things of that nature. Big pieces of the puzzle. I think that this year we still have, particularly at some of the position groups, we're still pretty young. And so guys are still strengthening up. Off seasons are going to still be a big deal as far as leaps forward and strength and conditioning and just overall size. And then the big thing I think for this season that we're going to see as far as a difference between the beginning of the season and the end of the season is the ironing out of the details of the game. Last year was the big puzzle pieces. Now we're going to fill in the details. And by the end of the year, I think you're going to see a difference in the execution of game plans to a fine detail, the beginnings of perfection and a veteran execution of game plans and schemes. The players are going to learn the nuances of their positions much better. And that's not to say that this team won't have a prolific year. We could even bust the BCS. I just mean that 2014 may be really the kind of the start to reach the ceiling of what this team can do. And I think this year's still going to be a developmental process. So as I go through these position groups, I want you to keep in mind that we're talking about Boise State and Boise State alone. This team in a vacuum. We're not talking about Boise State in relation to team X, Y, or Z. So don't get flustered if I critique some of the position groups, saying that there could be big changes by the end of the year, because what I'm not saying is that this team is going to be bad at the beginning of the year. That's not my intent. It's just that this team is going to continue to progress. Also, with the some of the classes and the weights for the players that I have in this video, I got them off of broncosports.com. Bronco Sports will list a player as a freshman or a sophomore, for example, but not necessarily whether or not they've redshirted. So to some extent, I may have had to go off of memory and in some cases just outright guess. If you've got any corrections, those are more than welcome. Also, the weights are 2012 weights for these players. And as I alluded to before, off-season strength and conditioning for these guys, especially the underclassmen, a lot of times we'll see quite a bit of a difference. For example, I think Jay Ajayi came in at around 210 pounds his true freshman year. He redshirted, and by the time he got to the field last year, he was a 222-pound beast. So these guys can pack on a lot of muscle in a fairly short amount of time. Their bodies are young. It's adapting to that very quickly, and the frames they have often will carry a lot more weight than what they're coming in as. So that's a big deal. One of the unique qualities of college football rosters as opposed to pro NFL rosters is you have a lot of turnover. It happens fairly rapidly. At most, you're going to have a player for 4 years. And so there's quite a bit of a dramatic shift every 2 to 4 years with personnel turnover. And because of that, any college football team is pretty much in a constant state of development. But that said, there's a stark difference between a team that's loaded with redshirt juniors and seniors and one that consists primarily of redshirt sophomores and juniors with maybe even some freshmen sprinkled in. We're really young at our position groups at some of them. Actually, some of them were not nearly as young as I thought we were, but we're still pretty young in several of them. And though we have a lot of talent, the inexperience factor, it just about dictates that we're going to have a second consecutive season of significant development. And I think that this team, once again, is going to be performing at a much higher level by year's end than they were at the beginning. And again, that's not to say that they're going to be bad at the beginning. I just think you're going to really be excited at the end of the year as you start to really start to see the intricacies of the game come together for this whole team, and it starts to execute at a really high level. I think that's going to be a blast to witness. That said, we are trying to bring in quite a few JUCO players. The thing on JUCO players, at least in my opinion, is it's real dependent on the position as to what you're going to get as far as how ready they are right out the gate. A lot of times teams want to bring in JUCO players because you have a greater degree of maturity. You have usually a higher level. Normally JUCO players are about a year ahead in their physical development and their skill progression. But something that happens with some of these positions is that they'll be a year behind in their knowledge and execution or ability to execute our playbook because they're learning quite a bit of stuff that's different than what they've been running. Now, it's not true of everything. For example, DeMarcus Lawrence came in last year and just really had an amazing season. I don't know any Boise State fans that aren't tremendously excited about DeMarcus Lawrence and how he came in and performed right off the bat. But you have to think about that. He's a defensive end, right? And in high school and most colleges, they play 4-3s. Well, we play a 4-2-5, okay. But on the defensive line, the responsibilities are pretty much the same. And for a defensive end, that's to rush the passer and to set the edge against the run. So he came in already pretty much ready to play that position. Now, an opposite example would be Dextral Simmons. He was a linebacker at Blinn College, where Cam Newton won a junior national championship. And he came over here to Boise State, and we put him at nickelback in the 4-2-5. Well, now all of a sudden he's got a lot more coverage responsibilities than he's probably ever had. That nickelback position really has free rein and latitude over the entire field. He can play as a safety, or he can play as a linebacker. He can blitz. He can crash the pocket, or he can pull back to a medium zone or a flat zone or even a deep zone. He can kind of go where he deems necessary, but in order to do that and do it correctly, you have to know the entire playbook forwards and backwards, and you have to be really good at reading your keys. And so that's a position that would probably take, I'm guessing, you know, I'm not a football player myself. I'm just a fan, but I'm guessing that would take a lot more development and study than the transition as a defensive end. So that's an example and something to keep in mind. We've got a JUCO running back coming in. I'll get to him later in the video. I expect him to probably compete right off the bat because aside from pass protection, running back is probably one of the most instinct-driven positions on the football field at any level. Either you can see that hole or that seam or that cutback lane and you can burst through it, or you simply can't. And it happens so fast that it's those instincts that drive that. Whereas a safety or a middle linebacker, they're going to have a lot more to run, to learn in the nuance of their position. So that'll wrap it up for the intro. And the next video will be starting out with the offensive side of the ball, and I'll begin with a brief overview of the coaching, the offensive coaching. That'll be the first section that we hit, and then after that we'll start getting into the position groups. This has been PJohn56 with One Bronco Nation Under God, and I hope you guys have a great day.